Hello and welcome, this is Dr. Alan here from the Dr. Eye Health Show, helping you learn all about the eyes, vision, finding the best vision products. Now today, we are talking about a blinding eye condition called age-related macular degeneration, also known as AMD for short. And being February, it happens to be AMD or Macular Degeneration Awareness Month, so I figured we'd shed some light on the subject. Now, if you or a family member are ever diagnosed with macular degeneration, your doctor will likely tell you if you either have dry macular degeneration or if you have wet macular degeneration. And so I figured we'd kind of go over the differences between these two to fully understand what's happening, your risks, and ultimately the different treatments that are available. So let's go over the difference between wet versus dry macular degeneration. Plus, if you stay tuned toward the end, I'll share three quick tips that, if you incorporate these tips into your lifestyle, should help reduce your chances of ever getting this terrible blinding disease, and if you're somebody who already has it, should even help slow down and reduce your risk of it getting worse. So yeah, you may want to stay tuned for that. Otherwise, let's just jump into it. Now, age-related macular degeneration is, again, a potentially blinding eye condition, but as the name implies, it is age-related. So usually people don't develop AMD till they're at least 50 years of age or older. And the older you get, the more likely you are to get this disease. Now, what is so devastating about macular degeneration is the part of the eye that's involved. Again, in the name, it says macular degeneration, and that has to do with the part of the retina in the back of the eye called the macula. The macula is the center bullseye of the retina in the back of the eye. It sends the light signals that pertain to the very center of your vision. So if you're somebody who's, you know, you're looking at a friend right in the face and you have macular degeneration, you may not be able to identify your friend because their face may be all blurry or could be completely blotched out. Another symptom that is really frustrating for people with this disease is that it can affect their ability to read. Because oftentimes when people are reading, they have these little blind spots, especially in the dead center of their vision, and that's the part of their eye that helps them see the details in order to make out letters and words. And so it just becomes very, very challenging for these people with macular degeneration. Now again, macular degeneration is broken into two different forms. There's dry macular degeneration and wet. Now, dry macular degeneration is by far the most common and affects about 85% of everybody diagnosed with the disease. And thankfully, dry macular degeneration is usually less severe. In fact, a lot of people who are diagnosed with the early to intermediate stages of the disease may never have much visual deficiency at all. Typically, the first symptoms that somebody gets when they're developing macular degeneration is something like night blindness. They have a harder time seeing in dim light and low light situations. In fact, that's why one of the newer technologies for even detecting early macular degeneration is basically a dark adaption test that some eye clinics may have. If you want to learn more about that test, I'll put that in the links in the description below because I think it's pretty cool. It's not available in all eye clinics, but it's becoming more popular. So again, you can check that out in the description below. Otherwise, many people don't even know that they're developing this disease until they go see their eye doctor so that they can look inside the eye and start seeing different signs within the retina, which we use to identify and diagnose macular degeneration. One of these first things that your doctor may identify and tell you about is the buildup of a protein called drusen. This drusen is kind of a yellowish material, a little protein stuck behind the retina, but it'll show up during an eye exam. Depending on the size of this drusen buildup material and the number that are appearing in the back of the eye, your doctor may begin to diagnose different levels of dry macular degeneration. Now, as dry age-related macular degeneration advances, eventually these drusen may disappear, but oftentimes the retina itself begins to atrophy, and we call that geographic atrophy. And that's, again, another thing that your doctor may mention to you. Unfortunately, when someone progresses from earlier stages of dry macular degeneration to this later end stage that has geographic atrophy, these individuals who have that often start having permanent blank spots in their vision, and that can lead to essentially legal blindness. And that can be really unfortunate because we just don't have a treatment for that end stage of the disease. Now again, usually dry macular degeneration is the most common, and it usually progresses very slowly. It's something that doesn't really advance super fast. You probably aren't going to notice sudden vision loss or changes like that, but it's really important that you continue to see your doctor so that they can figure out what stage you're at, your risk factors, and be able to educate you about the best forms of treatment for you. But then again, there is the form of wet age-related macular degeneration. And wet macular degeneration usually comes on much more sudden with more serious vision changes. What happens in wet macular degeneration is that the walls of the retina, between the retina and the back of the eye, called the choroid. The choroid is a meshwork of very tiny blood vessels. These tiny blood vessels begin to grow into the retina itself, and they act kind of like leaky garden hoses that leak fluid inside of the eye, usually a serous or blood-like fluid, and that inside of the eye looks wet compared to the dry form. So that's why we call it wet macular degeneration versus dry macular degeneration. Usually individuals with wet macular degeneration, again, notice sudden vision changes. Their vision may appear warped or distorted. In fact, that's my favorite term of all of eye care, is the term for when your vision looks warped and distorted. We call that metamorphopsia. I just love how it sounds. Even though my wife thinks that it sounds like it's from a Dr. Seuss book, I think it's cool. But because this warpage of your vision can sometimes be difficult to tell when it's really subtle, that's why a lot of doctors will hand out a special grid line sheet called an Amsler grid. This is something that a lot of patients can put on their fridge or keep by a workbench or their desk so they can just check on their vision periodically to see if there's any little subtle changes. Unfortunately, when somebody is diagnosed with macular degeneration, there really is only one treatment for that form of disease right now, and that is getting injections of medications into the back of the eye. These medications are anti-cancer medications called anti-VEGF, and these injections can help slow down or reverse some of that buildup of fluid in the back of the eye. And what's really important is that the sooner your doctor is able to identify that you're having this wet macular degeneration, the sooner you can get treatment and the better the outcomes. So if you're somebody who's noticing these sudden vision changes and you know you're at risk for macular degeneration, then you definitely want to see your doctor right away. But there you have it. That's the real difference between dry macular degeneration versus wet macular degeneration. The dry form has a little protein buildups and eventually atrophy of the retina in the back of the eye, where wet macular degeneration is where new blood and fluid begins to leak inside the back of the eye. Now, since you've made it through the video so far, I do want to share a couple of tips that you can change in your lifestyle, different products that you can use that can help slow down or reduce your risk of ever getting macular degeneration. But before we go over that, quick, let me know in the comments if you have macular degeneration, if it runs in your family, or if you have any other questions about age-related macular degeneration. I'd love to get back to you guys and make future videos on the topic. So let me know your questions in the comments section below, and I look forward to seeing them. Now the three tips here, I'm just gonna be really quick about them. The first big one is you need to eat healthy, specifically eating a diet that is rich in green leafy vegetables. In fact, it is recommended to consider eating some sort of a plant-based Mediterranean diet that includes oily fish, nuts and seeds, and again, lots of green leafy vegetables. This has a lot of micronutrients, which has been shown to help reduce the risk of getting macular degeneration. So again, start eating very healthy. Tip number two is to consider start taking eye vitamins. Specifically, if you're taking eye vitamins for macular degeneration, you want to take one that says AREDS2 written on the label. That is based off of major studies that found that high supplementation of taking antioxidant vitamins could reduce the risk of advancing macular degeneration by 25% over 5 years. However, I do encourage you that if you're going to consider taking eye vitamins, make sure you talk with your local eye care professional if that is something they would recommend for you. But if you happen to want to check out and look more into taking eye vitamins, my favorite brand called I Promise, I do have an affiliate with them, and you can save $1 off if you want to check out the link I'll put in the description below. They make vitamins of all different kinds for all different ages and types of eye conditions. Tip number three is that if you or a family member who has risk of macular degeneration, if you smoke, you need to stop. Many, many studies have found that cigarette smoke is strongly associated with a higher risk and advancement of more severe forms of macular degeneration. So thankfully, it is a dose-dependent relationship. So the less you smoke, the less chance you have of having complications. And if you're somebody who's quit smoking and haven't smoked for 20 years, you have essentially the same risk as someone who's never smoked. So yes, quit smoking. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video and want to learn more about different eye conditions and what you can do about them, hit that like button for me and subscribe to the channel. Otherwise, again, this is Dr. Alan here from Dr. Eye Health. Keep an eye on it, and we'll talk to you soon.